The forEach loop in Swift UI is not suited for asynchronous work because it doesn't support the use of wait within its closure. This means that asynchronous tasks inside a forEach loop will run concurrently and without proper order or error handling, which can lead to unpredictable behavior. In this video, I will show you how to build a proper async-compatible loop that handles asynchronous tasks sequentially, giving you full control over execution flow, error management, and more reliable async logic. Also, check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description, and more on this in the video later on. So today we are going to talk about async forEach and what's it for, how to use it in a Swift UI project. Well, first of all, you already know what a forEach loop is. We're just going to go through all of the elements of an array. Now, async forEach is just going to help us a lot more with asynchronous functionality. Let's just start off by adding a simple example with the forEach. So I'm going to remove all of this and add a simple button right over here with a title of tab me. And then the action will be, let's just go through an array of 1 till, let's just go 10, and then just go for each. And then we are going to have here an I or an index. And then I'm going to move this inside a functionality, a simple function. We'll see later on, I'm going to add the async throwing functionality later on. So let's just have a function of some function. And I'm going to pass along our index. So index, and then that will be an int value. And let's just print out our index. So on the tap of a button, I'm going to use this sum function with an index of I. Okay, so let's just see it. Let's just tap over there. And if we take a look at the console, right over here, under the preview, we can see that indeed, it's just going to count up from 1 till 10. Now, let's just see this actually while I'm tapping it. I'm going to clear it out and then tap again. As you can see, it's instant. And that's how it should be, of course. It should be really fast. It just go through the elements real quickly. But what if I have an asynchronous throwing function that does some fetches or whatever from the server? It waits a little bit till it gets its results and then moves over to the next functionality, you know, just triggering the next action. As a Swift UI developer, the right mentor can fast track your growth and save you years of frustration. That's exactly what my one-on-one mentoring sessions are designed for. I offer personalized, hands-on guidance tailored to your goals. With deep experience in iOS development and a proven track record of helping developers level up, I will support you in overcoming challenging, mastering Swift UI, and building high-quality apps. Ready to take your iOS skills to the next level? The link is in the description. For that, I'm going to mimic this on the sum function. I'm going to sleep for 1 second, so try await task.sleep for sleep 4, and I'm going to go for dot seconds 1. Okay, so now we do need an asynchronous throwing functionality. Well, we need to encompass it, but I'm not going to do the task and the do catch right over here. I'm going to make the actual function async throws. Okay, and that will take care of this error, but we did not do anything much because then it's going to ask it right over here. So I'm going to do that right over here. So let's just put it into a task that takes care of the asynchronous nature of the function. And then we want to add the try right over here. Okay, and try await too. So now that the error went away, let's just tap on the button. And what gives? After 1 second, we have this, but it's not as what we expect. So it's 2, 3, all the way up to 10, and then 1. It's all over the place. Also, I don't want this to present all of the elements after 1 second. I want the elements printed out at a second at a time. So that's what we want. So for that, we are going to create an async forEach, and that will be an extension on the sequence. So I'm just going to scroll down over here and create an extension on sequence. And let's just create a function called asynchronous. There we go. And we're going to have an operation right over here. I'm going to type it out and do an explanation after I type it out, because it's a little bit complicated to just type and explain. So operation. And we are going to have an element. Okay, that's the element from the sequence. And that will be an asynchronous throwing operation. And it's just going to be also a completion. So we are going to return void on the completion right over there. And also this function will be, of course, asynchronous. And because the element is throwing, we need to make this as a re-throwing function. So re-throws, just like that. And then, AI is suggesting what I actually want. I'm going to go through each of the elements, and then I'm going to try await and do the operation with that element. Okay, let's just see that. Oh, it's not just throw, it's froze. And that should go away right now. There we go. So that is our async for each extension on the sequence. As you can see, it needs an operation that is asynchronous throwing, and then encompasses that inside a completion, which is asynchronous re-throwing. And we just go through all of the elements with the try await operation. Okay, so now let's modify our for each on the tap of the button. First of all, we already know that this for each, you know, it's going to be asynchronous. So we are going to move our task outside of the loop. So let's hit Control I right over here, so we have better indentation, and then change this to async for each. And because this is an asynchronous throwing, it has asynchronous throwing functionality, we are going to add try await before the async for each. And that should do it. So now we have asynchronously looping through 1 till 10. So let's test this out. Let's clear everything right over here. And let's click on the button. There we go. And then after 1 second, 1, 2, 3, and all the way up to 10, it will go. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.